Our next guest is a close friend of the project, and there's nothing that gets him fired up like some 1D drama. The very funny Luke McGregor joins us.
Thank you.
There are certain protocols we need to follow on television.
Steve, that must be breaking your heart. Yeah. To see them not get along.
Please explain.
Well, One Direction are a band that don't exist anymore, and now one of them is bad-mouthing the previous members.
Huge conflicts. Okay. They're supposed to be brothers and best friends, and they've fallen out. You are a sensitive soul and a very logical person. How do you come back from a breakup with a friend?
My best friend, Celia Piccola, obviously your equal best friend.
Thank you very much.
We made a best friend video. We recorded a best friend video and to say, hey, I know we're not getting along right now, but I love you and blah, blah, blah. So we actually recorded a video that if we ever broke up, we would watch the video to get us back together.
Was this when you were in kindergarten or more?
We were like 37.
Okay.
actual video?
We made a video.
Not like VHS video.
We sat down together and... not a VHS. I think it was an MP4. and then we lost it, but that was our plan.
Have you ever had to pull it out?
No, we made it because we were fighting a lot, and then once we made the video, we kind of resolved our issues in the video, and then after that, we got along really well. So if you're watching One Direction, make a video.
Rosehaven was a beautiful show to watch, but the bloodshed behind the scenes was absolutely amazing.
It was brutal.
It's a great way to sort out a conflict. There's no doubt about that, Luke. Do you want to have a go at another conflict? Because we've got the gas crisis we've just been chatting about.
I'd actually like to just talk about this, because this fascinates me. And I know that economist came on and said that pulling the gas trigger is not the answer. I think it absolutely is.
You're disagreeing with our economist, Angela Jackson.
We produce more gas than we need. So the first thing I would do as the government is to say, all right, well, let's service the domestic markets first, even though there obviously are going to be costs in distribution, and then allow the excess to go overseas. But the fact that we're allowing these long-term contracts with suppliers internationally to make Australia have a shortage is crazy to me. I absolutely think we should pull the gas trigger.
I'm about to make a video that explains why I'm never going to ask you about the gas crisis. I hope you understand.
It's basically
watch it later.
Australia produces more gas than it needs, a lot more gas than it needs, and then we have our distributors have long-term overseas contracts where they have to give the gas to overseas buyers.
Yeah.
So pulling the gas trigger means that we maintain enough gas for the domestic market. They have to. So I think they should do that immediately.
Really, I think it's a nice idea. I think it needs a better punchline, though. That's it.
I'm so glad we promoted this segment. It's some much needed laughs.
I said on the phone, I said, I just want to talk about gas.
It makes a lot more sense in One Direction. You've just finished three shows at the Sydney Opera House. How'd you go?
Do we have to move off from gas? I really want to talk about gas.
What's the gas like?
We've got enough gas.
Good. I had my first positive heckler.
Oh, I like that.
My first, and I told a joke and I wasn't sure about it. In the same way, me ranting about gas. and I said, I don't think I should have told that joke. And then this guy yelled out, I'm glad you did. And I said, sorry. And he goes, oh, I'm glad you told that joke. And I went, thank you. That's really kind. So that was a and you know, it's just nice to play the Opera House. Not a big deal, but
we promise you, he will not be talking about gas tonight. On Have You Been Paying Attention?
Yes. It's important though.
It's tonight at 8:40 on 10. Thank you so much for joining us, the gorgeous Luke McGregor.